Decay, rotten and missing teeth, all before starting primary school. Research out today has found about 40% of children in Tamaki Makaurau, Auckland and in Northland have dental cavities. For more on our dental health problem, we're joined by Revive a Smile founder, Dr. Assil Russell. Tēnā koe, Assil. Thanks for being with us this morning. How bad are our young children's teeth?
Tēnā koe, Jack. Well, it's pretty bad. So through our work with Revive a Smile, we travel around New Zealand thanks to the help of Southern Cross Health Trust. And I would actually go as far as to say that this problem isn't just isolated to Auckland and Northland. It's widespread across New Zealand. There are many children out there who are suffering from infections in their teeth, rampant tooth decay. And unfortunately, the system is not coping with the amount of children that need dental treatment. It's pretty bad.
Why do children have such problems with their teeth?
So I think the problem really comes down to lack of access to oral health therapists, lack of parents enrolling their children with the school dental systems, lack of access to fluoridated water supplies, and yeah, just lack of access to education. A lot of parents don't realise what the causes of tooth decay actually are, and so they might be unintentionally harming their children's teeth through a high sugary diet, you know, baby bottles with sweetened milk in them, things like that.
Really though, parents don't understand what causes bad teeth? Surely we all know that having a high sugar diet, and particularly sugary drinks, is really, really bad for kids' teeth.
Yeah, you would think so, Jack. I mean, I think in a lot of parts in New Zealand, especially in high-risk groups, and we've seen a lot of this with the Māori and Pacific Island communities and other isolated communities in rural New Zealand, that education isn't always there. Just last week, we had a mother of four come to our clinic, our charity clinic from Tokoroa, and she didn't realise that putting her baby to sleep with milk and a little bit of honey was a bad thing. So, education is there, but it's not reaching far enough to cover all the people that need to be educated. And there's a lot of good work that's being done by the New Zealand Dental Association, who's partnered up with Colgate and Plunkett. They do a lot of educational programs, and they distribute a lot of toothbrushes and toothpaste and things like that. But I think more needs to be done.
What else could we do?
Well, I think the government really does need to step up, so the Ministry of Health need to do more promotion around this topic to combat the problem. Also, community water fluoridation is a huge initiative that needs to be undertaken, I believe, nationwide. Introducing something like a sugar tax will also help a lot. It would deter parents from those unhealthy foods. Making healthy foods more affordable is also a good option. So there's a lot of things out there that can be done. But I think what it really does come down to is raising awareness of the problem as you're doing, because far too many young Kiwi children are suffering in New Zealand, and it's really heartbreaking to see.
It must be so hard when you have parents come and see you and they think their kids are healthy and well, and then you look inside their mouths and you just see a disastrous set of teeth.
Yep, absolutely. It's very hard, and it's very hard on the parents as well. More often than not, it's not something, you know, that they want to see. They're not proud of it. A lot of the time they come to see us for their own teeth, and then we ask them about their children and we find out that their children aren't even enrolled. So it is free in New Zealand. More people need to be taking the initiative and enrolling their children, getting them into the system from a very early age. So you know, as soon as their teeth come out, even before then, they can be going and seeing the dental therapist and getting those teeth and gums checked out.
Well, yeah, thanks for your advice, as always, Assil, and thanks for the great work you do. We really appreciate it. That's Dr. Assil Russell from Revive a Smile.